Cam girls, video performers who stream live webcam broadcasts, commonly in a sexual manner, to paying viewers. The first webcamming website was created by American college student Jenny Ringley in 1996, who set up webcams in her college dorm with certain angles exclusive to paying members. Today, the webcamming phenomenon has exploded to become a multi-billion dollar industry with at least 12,000 cam models online at any given moment and over 240,000 viewers online at any given time. My name's Anthony Padilla, and today I'm going to be sitting down with cam girls to learn the truth behind this taboo underground profession. Are cam girls in this line of work simply to make enough money to pay the bills and get by? Or are they really just addicted to the power they have over their customers, manipulating them in order to drain them of every dollar in their pocket? Is camming just a harmless form of self-expression for these women? Or has it been twisted into a fast track for manipulative perverts to live out their darkest sexual fantasies? Hey, Lydia.
Hi.
Lana.
Hi.
Sabina.
Hi.
Thank you so much for coming out and teaching me about the wondrous world of cam girls.
You're welcome. I'm gonna teach you everything.
What do you consider yourself? A cam girl? A webcam model?
I call myself a cam girl, a content creator.
An online content creator. I do all kinds of content, but mostly I'm known for my adult content, and part of that is camming.
Yeah, I'm more like a webcam model and friend.
And friend.
Yeah, like I'm here for friendship and fantasy.
Before we learn more about the wondrous world of cam girls, I wanted to take a quick moment to mention that Adam and Eve is sponsoring this episode. Yes, this is super important. As other topics I've covered relating to nudity and sexuality, like my video with nudists and strippers, were completely demonetized. And that is harmful to this series because it also blacklists these videos and prevents them from being recommended to new audiences who may be impacted by these topics. So in case you're not aware, AdamandEve.com is an online retailer for erotic gifts, and they donate 20% of their profits to help fight the spread of HIV around the world, which I think is really f***ing cool. So use code CAM, that's C-A-M, on AdamandEve.com to get 50% off one item, plus free shipping in the US and Canada. Please go support the hell out of this company for making this episode possible so I could pay my wonderful crew for the hundreds upon hundreds of hours that go into making each and every single one of these episodes. That's all I wanted to say. Now back to learning about the wondrous world of cam girls. What does being a cam girl entail?
I feel like it's like being a virtual stripper.
Virtual stripper.
You're like entertaining someone and you're getting tips for entertaining them.
You're like your own boss, but you're also kind of like a therapist, like a little sex therapist when you're on there. Yeah, it's really cool. You get to know a lot of people and you get to really see who they are deep down because they don't show that side to anyone else.
Right, they get to say exactly what they're thinking.
100%, and that's where it gets really fun because then you're like, I get to see this part of a person that has never been seen by a majority of people who say they know them, you know? And it's like really cool that they trust me with that.
How long have you been a cam girl?
2 years.
I started camming in 2018.
I've been a cam girl for 2.5 years now. I tried it right when I turned 18 when I was still in high school, yeah. And I failed miserably.
How'd you fail?
I didn't know what I was doing. I just thought, oh, you log on and you flash your tits and you make money. So I logged on, I flashed my tits and I made like $15 and then I logged off. And I
What first made you want to become a cam girl?
I was a little bit bored with what I was doing. I was just making adult content, but I already had sort of like a following. So one of my girlfriends was like, you should really try camming. And I was hesitant because, you know, when you're creating content like we're doing right now, this is not what everyone's gonna see. You're gonna edit it.
I edit all the parts out that make me look dumb,
exactly.
That would get me canceled.
Now I wanna go through your files.
Do you remember your first time performing as a cam girl?
I think I was really flustered and really worried because there's like a bunch of people in your room and some of them don't understand how it works.
Yeah.
Some of them are like, why aren't you naked and f***ing a horse? And they're just so angry and they don't understand. And then I'm also like, okay, where's that? Where did I put it? And so it was like a lot of chaos in my first session.
The first time I did it, I was wearing a mask.
You're wearing a mask?
I was so scared. So I wore a masquerade mask. I was online for like 8 hours And like after about five, I was like, fuck it.
Are there any rules or guidelines that you set for yourself for your camming experiences?
My rules are pretty much like no making demands. If you ask for something, you have to tip for it. There's always a tip menu and you get to see what I offer. My no's in general are like, I won't do any pee or poop stuff, but it's not generally allowed, although people will request it.
Keep those things in a toilet.
Yeah.
I won't do anything that I don't want to do for money, no matter what. Yeah. I've been offered thousands and thousands of dollars for things that I just don't want to do.
Right.
And I get asked a lot to like pretend like I'm dead.
What?
Okay, and that kind of freaks me out because I'm like, why do you want to see me dead?
There's like some kind of deep-rooted
what is that called when you like dead body? Yep.
Yeah. Do you proudly tell people you're a cam girl, or is that something that you keep more of a secret?
I have to proudly tell people that I'm a cam girl because if I act like, oh, hey, I'm a cam girl, then like people are going to have room to talk. But if I'm like, hello, I'm a cam girl, they're not going to be like, oh, you poor thing. They're going to be like, I'm going to feel stupid if I bash her about this.
Yeah, I tell them that I'm a cam girl if they're like females. But like, but like with everybody else that could be of a threat, I'm always like, music producer.
Right.
You know, just in case.
Is there a reason that you tend to not tell men what it is that you do?
From my experience, I've had men where they just lose self-control and they start saying and doing things that are just like no one would do on their daily lives just because like I'm considered a cam girl or in the industry. So it's like they just kind of like lose boundaries or humility sometimes.
How quickly after meeting you does someone find out that you're a cam girl?
It depends on who they are. Like if they're my dentist, I'm never gonna tell them that I'm a cam girl. I'm just gonna be like, oh, I work in social media. Like I just lie.
I mean, it's not that
it's
big
not
of a lie.
It's not that big of a lie.
It's a truth.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna walk up to like a boy's parents and be like, hello, I show my on the internet.
Right,
nice to meet you. But the average person, especially because I live in LA, I'm able to just be like, yeah, I'm a cam girl. And they're just like, all right, cool.
Is camming more of a supplemental income or is it your only source of income?
You need like several jobs.
Really?
I work in camming, I do lesbian and then I'm a music producer on top of like content creator and music writer. So it's like you're really trying to do everything just to be able to make it by because it's definitely just like making minimum wage.
Do you feel like you get paid appropriately for your line of work?
No.
No?
I should get paid way more. And I've even had like, and I know that sounds kind of like narcissistic, but like I've actually been told from some girls, they're like, you're not making enough.
Like, I feel like I get paid more than appropriately
really?
For the work that I do, yes.
Yeah, so you think you get paid too much?
No, 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 I'm very grateful. And at first when I started doing this in 2016, I had way less followers and I was just blown away by how much I was able to make in my first month. So like, I'm very baffled by the fact that I'm still doing it.
Have you ever been harassed or stalked by a viewer?
I had one guy looking through my window at one point and it scared the hell out of me because
I
was playing video games. And
you
I was just like-
You looked up and you see a guy in your window?
I was playing video games on like the TV screen, like when it went black is when I saw this person and I was like, what the f-? And I looked around and I was so scared. Now I like have to have roommates.
What did you do about the guy at your house?
I called the police and the police got it handled and everything like that. Apparently he's a streaker that they've been finding. So yeah,
wow.
I found him.
What's the most you've ever been paid for a single session?
So the most I've ever made was $1,800.
In one session?
Yes.
Oh, but lawyers. You thought you went to school for a high paying job if you tried cam girling?
A single tipper was $3,600, which you split that with the cam site usually.
Right.
So you get half of that. I don't think I ever had another tip that came close to that.
That's wild.
Yeah.
Has being in this industry changed the way that you view sex and sexuality?
So my first interview that I ever did, they asked what I was into and I literally had no idea. Like I remember scrambling and being like, what do I like sexually? Like I have no idea. And now I just have like the longest list ever and like it'd be easier to say what I'm not into.
Do you feel that being a cam girl has made you feel empowered?
Definitely. I hated myself before I started this job. And now like I love myself so much.
100%. It's made me love myself more. It's made me figure out more about myself and it's made me fall in love with every individual person that comes around with it. Like I have fallen in love with every single person that comes into my cam room.
Are your feelings ever hurt when people equate cam girls to what they call prostitutes?
I just get annoyed because it's like I'm trying to convince people and they really don't believe me that I don't do that. And then it gets frustrating because someone might buy your content, spend a lot of money tipping you, and then all of a sudden he's being a jerk and is like, why won't you meet me at the lobby of the blank hotel? And you're like, really, you're gonna be that guy?
They expect that actual interaction to expand into a real life.
Yeah, they just can't imagine that you're willing to do things with your body for money, and that is not one of them. They cannot process that.
Why do you think so many people have such harsh judgments against camming?
We're taught that sexuality is bad, that people shouldn't embrace their sexuality. Yeah. So I feel like it's not necessarily their fault. They're just a victim of how they were brought up.
I think it's because what you don't know, you're usually afraid of, or you usually judge.
It's like built on misconceptions.
Yeah, like people are always like, I wonder how your parents feel about this. But my daddy was over here like, you know, you were born naked, you're gonna die naked. Why not make money naked too? And I'm
damn,
like,
damn, that's true. What's been your most bizarre fan experience?
I signed at a convention. You sign photos, fans come to meet you at the convention.
Yeah.
And someone had printed out the most ugly photo of me dick and was just like, can you please sign this? And I'm looking at it so horrified, but to them this is like a masterpiece photo. They cannot wait for me to sign this. They're gonna put it on the wall, and I'm just seeing this and I'm like, you need to make better content, girlfriend.
One guy came up to me and he was like, hi, are you Sabina Rouge? And I'm like, yeah. And he goes, I love your art. And I'm just like, thank you. And he was like, can all my friends get a picture? And you just look over and it's just like all these little kids, like not little kids, all these 18-year-old and up people, yeah. We're over there just like...
They're like basically at the Sabina Rouge fan club, and you just so happen to be there.
They look like they were fangirling. I thought it was so cute.
Pecan wants to know what you do when a regular gets too attached.
When a regular gets too attached, I definitely try to remind them that I'm here for friendship and fantasy. And if there's anything else you want, just know that it's not going to be. That's what I always try to tell them. Mm-hmm. I'm like, keep that in mind. I'm not here for love. I'm either gonna take your wife or your sister.
Tessa wants to know if you've ever had a camming experience with someone you knew.
So my ex-boyfriend's friends, they like sometimes watch me cam, and they'll like private message me while I'm on cam and be like, hey, this is so-and-so. And I'm like, oh, sh-.
People from my high school like buy my private content where they could just like watch my, but it's like a curiosity thing, you know?
Right.
If I found out someone from my high school was doing, I would totally buy their content and watch.
True.
Hell yeah.
True. All your high school curiosities just right
yeah,
there
like,
in
I
one
see
moment.
You naked.
If there's anyone watching who wants to become a cam girl, but is maybe nervous about the risks, or maybe is nervous about the negative stigma and the judgment surrounding it.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any warning or advice you'd want to give them?
Everyone you know will find out, like your grandma will find out, everyone. So just get that out of the way. It can be a lot of fun and very worth it, but just know that there's a lot of dangers. Reach out to other girls and ask what the hard parts of the industry are, because it's not all easy. It can be dangerous, it can change your life, it can ruin like future opportunities that they have.
True.
So
once that choice is made, there's no turning back.
There's no turning back. Like my cam recordings from when I was barely 18 are on the internet still.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be on the internet for the rest of my life.
What's one thing you wish you could say to all cam girl viewers?
We're not here for your enjoyment only. We're here to keep you happy and horny and healthy, but also...
the three H's of life.
The three H's of life.
It's okay to buy doesn't make you a loser. It actually makes you really cool. So I'm just saying.
Totally not biased. What do your friends and family think about your career as a cam girl?
I don't know if my parents know specifically that I cam.
Oh.
Like, I don't know what my dad knows about what I do. I just...
You've never brought it up.
I mean... The last time that I heard about what my dad knew about my career, he said something like, she does bad stuff on YouTube, which like, if that's what he thinks I do,
yeah.
Then I don't ever want to tell him what I actually do.
Yeah.
My mom is just like, she's in denial still. She still thinks I'm like on a phase with the whole girl thing. She's like, no, this is all a phase. I'm like, girl, I'm nominated for best eater now. Is it really a phase? But
has being a cam girl ever affected any of your relationships? Yeah, how so?
When I'm dating women, it's like they all think I'm cheating on them. So I'm just like, no. And then if you ever decide to date like men, they're over here like, I don't like that.
I mean, my partner doesn't care that I cam. He doesn't really want to be around when I'm camming.
Right.
Because then it's like he'd hear me like spanking myself from the other room like over and over again.
Like while he's cooking bacon in the
He just like
kitchen.
Doesn't want to be around during
it. What is it about being a cam girl that brings you the most joy?
One day, like I was like, you know, guys, I'm really sick. I've been working all week and I just feel so sick, but I have to work. And someone just tipped me out every goal and was like, okay, now go to bed. And I was like,
Thank Aww. You.
What do you think the biggest misconception surrounding cam girls in general is?
They think that we don't pay taxes. Oh my God, that one pisses me the f*** off.
People think you don't pay taxes?
They think that we don't pay taxes. Yeah. I want everyone to know that the government f***s me in the ass. Like, they take so much of my money. Like, yeah. It's terrible.
I swear to God, people think that we're just like vigorously masturbating all day long. Like,
you're like, my body is made of the same thing that your body is made of, and it can't, the human body can't yeah. handle that.
They'll be like, what are you doing right now? Are you super f***ed right now? And you're like, I'm chilling, dude.
You're like, I'm doing my taxes.
Like, I'm good, yeah.
Demonstration time. So I will fake like I am a viewer who's logging in for the first time to a session, and I don't know what to do or say, but I paid for a private session.
Okay.
All right, hey, Lydia.
Hey, what do you want to talk about today?
Sex.
Okay, oh, what kind of sex do you like?
Boobs.
Do you want to see my boobs?
Yes.
Are you sure that you deserve it?
No.
I really get off on encouragement, so do you think you could tip me like a little more?
Oh, really? More money is the encouragement that you need?
Yes. That makes me really wet.
I actually have a parting gift for you.
Yay!
The best interviewer shirt, which you could get at padildoshop.com, but for you, this is free.
Padildo?
Padildo Shop.
Wow, that's an amazing name.
Thank you. All right, you got 5 seconds to shout out or promote anything you want directly into camera. Go.
Subscribe to my OnlyFans and YouTube. Just search Lydia Love.
My Twitter is Lana the Plug, and I just want to say shout out to all the cam girls out there working super hard to make everyone happy.
Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. My Twitter is at Sabina Rouge, and my Instagram is TheSabinaRouge for more fun.
Hey, guys. If you want to make me really happy, like really, really happy, I'm going to need you to subscribe to Anthony Padilla right now.
Thank you so much,
yeah,
Sabina.
This is so much fun.
I feel like I understand the wondrous world of cam girls just a little bit more.
I hope so.
After spending the day with these cam girls, I've come to learn that they, just like anyone else, are trying to make a healthy living. In our society in which sex sells and sensationalized nudity is easily accessible to anyone at the click of a button, who are we to blame these women for taking advantage of this niche market and satisfying paying customers while doing exactly what they love? See you later, bye guys.
Press a like.
You right. can ask to the sloth.
You could if you
me.
Really wanted to. Yeah, I mean, like, looking between the two, I'm like, there's probably...
You're cute.
Yeah, leave a comment below which... No, don't. Don't. I'm not going to solicit that. I'm
not... You might not want to read those.
I am not going to solicit that.